Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I'm Nicholas Bayerle. This is my first quarantine video, so my skin looks pasty. My hair is starting to grow out over my ears right now. And I try to use a microphone over here, but now I have to use a boom mic because I freaking left my AA batteries at the office. I'm sure you guys can relate to what's going on right now. And if you're watching this later, these are going to be applicable to you as well. But I want to share with you guys four things right now after doing hundreds of phone calls with our other business owner clients across multiple different industries. The four lenses that you can put on to look through right now to make the correct pivots in your business and in your life that's going to allow you to up level in this time rather than feeling scared or taken back or not knowing exactly what to do. Now, there's a lot of stuff going on in the world, and I'm not here to give you opinions on what is going on in the world, but more so looking at what people are doing. I actually had a conversation with one of my friends the other day, and he says, Nicholas, like, this is what we should do. Why don't people see this? And he was telling me like all these things about how it should go. And if people would just be smart, then it would go this way. And I just told him, I was like, listen, man, like, people are people. What you think should happen and what's actually happening are completely different. And you want to look at your customers and treat your customers like they're smart during this time. Meaning, if you're just treating them like you want them to do the same thing, like an example would be this. There's lots of businesses that are open right now that are like restaurants, and let's say they don't believe in the coronavirus. They're like, oh, this is stupid, it's not a big deal, it's not as bad as cold, whatever. And I'm not saying that's what I believe, I'm just saying, what if they believe that? So they don't wear any gloves, they don't put masks on their employees, they're not washing their hands. When the customer comes in that actually buys the food, they're not gonna feel comfortable. So the upside of not wearing any gloves, there is almost no upside. The downside of not wearing gloves is that you lose tons of customers. You might get 1% a buy, but then people won't come back and they won't refer people. There is almost no downside to making sure that you're wearing gloves, you're wearing the mask, all these things. What I'm saying about that is that it doesn't matter necessarily what we believe about what's going on. It's what people believe, our customers believe, our clients believe, and we want to make sure that they feel safe. I think that's one of the biggest things right now is that making the customer feel intelligent, feel safe. Intelligent meaning not being afraid to address things that are going on in the world, the economic climate, the virus climate, the world climate, like all these different things that are going on. Not being afraid to address it. There's people that are putting their heads in the sand, or there's people that are just straight negative Nancys, and I don't think those are both great stances, but I do believe communicating like people are smart. Second thing is making them feel comfortable. Making them feel comfortable that you're gonna stay around, making them feel comfortable that you're still gonna continue to serve them, making them feel comfortable that you're making the shifts necessary to make them the number one person. Now, those are the four things, but I wanna make sure I put that blanket out there of like, right now, it's what the customer wants that matters. Because if we're just like, oh, this is what I think, what we think doesn't necessarily matter, it's what other people think that really matters when it comes down to it. So taking those precautions without compromising your personal brand and what you actually stand for. So after these hundreds of conversations that I've had with these different business owners, there's been a few things that have come up that were pretty consistent across the board. Because when the economy was just really good, people just had endless amounts of credit, they had a good job or they had a great business, it's very easy for them to invest in things without really needing a reason why. So number one is there's two different core motivations with humans, and that's the either away motivation or toward motivation. And one of my mentors, Russell Brunson, breaks this down really well in his book, Traffic Secrets, and he gives great examples of it, but he just gives you both examples. Towards, which is like, man, I want a six pack, or man, I want that dream house, or oh, I want that amazing marriage. Those are all towards motivations. Away motivations are like, I just don't feel comfortable in my body. I'm scared to go to the gym. Or I'm in an abusive relationship. I don't know how to be in the good relationship. Or something like, I don't feel secure in my job right now. So because of that, I want to do something different. And those are the two different types of motivations. And typically in a really good economy when everything's going amazing, the toward motivations work really well. This is like what Dean Graziosi would say is like aspirational marketing. Getting people to go where they always dreamed of. And it's like casting these big dreams. And one of the things my mentor, Russ Brunson, said that he learned from Dean Graziosi is Dean did well even after the economic collapse of 2008. And he said one of the biggest things, the shifts that he made that helped the most is he stopped being the aspirational marketer and instead became the life preserver, like the life raft, the thing that was saving them. And what I'm seeing right now is the away message works a little better. Is people are looking for something that's going to keep them away from the life that they don't want. And if you can position your product or service in that way, that's going to help. So that's not meaning fear or all these things. That's not what I'm talking about. It's just taking the two different types of motivations. Again, I'll put the description, Traffic Secrets, and a link to it. It's a free book you can grab for free, and it's a physical copy. You just cover shipping so we don't make Russell go broke. So, and it breaks it down in a simple format. So that was number one. Number two is something that we use in all of our marketing, and I've seen across the board, and this is from some of the smartest people in the world. You look at a sales page, you look at a YouTube video, you look at a webinar, you look at a live event, you look at a launch, you look at a car dealership, you look at all these things, and you're gonna find this. And typically there's three different types of motivated buyers, which is first is the emotional buyer. So I'm gonna give examples of our live events that we have or launches that we do in our online community. So you have an online and offline perspective. For the offline perspective of the live events, which right now we can't do, so we've had to pivot, but even the way we run the live events, very easy to see how we sell things. The first person that we cater to is gonna be the emotional buyer. This is like the impulse buyer, the person that wants it really, really fast, and if they can't get it fast, then they don't want it at all. If I were to look at a sales page of someone trying to sell a product online, typically this would be right when you click on before you even scroll down the page. This can be something that people say that's like, you know, a video that's exciting, like it gets people in the state and the well-being of like, oh my gosh, this is so amazing, with the ability to purchase right there. For people that are already decided, they're emotional, they're compulsive, they're like, oh my gosh, this looks amazing, I want to buy right now. And if that fades away, then they won't buy. And typically people are catering to these people. They're like, they're excited, they do a big launch, they make it so awesome. They promote the product that way, and all the emotional buyers are like, oh my gosh, this is so amazing. So at my live event, we definitely do this, and at any launch that I do, I'll do this as well, where I'm like, guys, this is the buildup, this is what you've been waiting for, this is amazing, this is what it's gonna do, this is what it's gonna do for you, go ahead and grab it, hurry, hurry, hurry. And that emotional excitement, compulsive person's like, oh my gosh, I want this. You wanna make sure you cater to that. The live event, I'll do it by just through the entire talk, I'll cater to the people that are like, I want to make a decision right now. So then what happens at my live event is the next day down the road, I'll go more towards the logical buyer. So you have emotional number one, logical number two. Logical is someone that wants to make a great decision. They want to make sure that they have their questions answered. They want to make sure that this is a good investment and they're not going to make a dumb decision or a quick decision that they're going to regret. So typically I'll do this by breaking down the actual facts about what this will do for them and what will happen if they don't have it. So an example, though I wouldn't use this normally, but it gets the point across, would be, hey guys, I'm selling this $1,000 product and I know you guys were interested in it. And I did the math that if you were to apply this to your business, let's just say on the low end, it would make you one sale. And one sale for your business is $3,000. So if we just got one sale, not 10 sales, not 100 sales, we're looking at about a 66% gain, right? Like, or 300% gain from the investment. We're like, oh my gosh, like with $1,000 and make $3,000, we made $2,000 and we invested $1,000. Like, we would do that all days of the week. And if we don't make that investment, you may keep that $1,000, but you may not have gained that extra customer, which means that by not buying, that would be $2,000 loss. And people start saying like, oh my gosh, yeah. And then you maybe can break down what's inside, what makes them get the one customer. So you're making sure that logically the actual decision makes sense. And the benefit is for even the emotional buyers, when they go home and their friends challenge them, their family challenge them on why did you invest money into your product here? They have the logical reasons why they invested. Oh my gosh, like you wouldn't believe it's gonna help me with this, 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 and this, and this, and that's why. And people are like, oh, that makes sense. So you want the logical side to make sense. On a sales page, this might be anything below that first part of the page. It starts explaining like what this does, what it does for you. It might have testimonials. It might have things in there that make sure that people understand that this is a valuable thing to have. So that's going to get the logical buyers that needed their questions answered. And then the last one's going to be FOMO buyers, fear of missing out. And this is something I see people are missing right now. And it's easy to do it when the economy is really good. You can really be lazy on this stuff. But when the economy is, or people are in a place of making more logical decisions with their money, you want to make sure that your logical decision that's worth making. No one will stop investing money in something that's helping them in some way where the thing is more valuable than the money, right? This is why people will still buy houses, which is so funny. The other day, someone told me, I said, will people still buy houses in down economy? People like, they were like, no. Like, you don't think anyone's going to buy a house in down economy. Like, you're joking. Like, smart people will buy tons of houses in a down economy. But also, other regular people will buy a house in a down economy. Why? Maybe even if they're downgrading, but it's still a lot of money. Might be 200 grand, 300 grand, 500 grand to buy a house. So price isn't the problem. Value is the problem. Because people will go out there and invest 200K in a house. Why can't they buy your toothpick or like an ear picker thing, a Q-tip, or whatever the thing is that you're selling? Coaching. As long as it's more valuable than the money that they have, they're going to vote with their dollars. And they want that logical thing that's going to back it up to make them go, okay, this makes sense right now. And maybe in your business, that might be reporting or really showing the benefits of what this actually does, the outcome that this produces, not just what's inside of the actual product. So you have urgency, scarcity, and then, or you have emotional, logical, and then you have the urgency, scarcity of the FOMO buyer. Urgency in your tone of voice, urgency in the actual time frame, and scarcity in the amount of items or the amount of people that can be involved. And what this does is it always allows you to put supply below demand. And so many times when things are good, you just open supply. If you want to buy the sweatshirt, buy it now. And the only way there's urgency is, oh, there's a sale for this much time. Yet, if you can limit supply below demand or limit the amount of people that get some type of a bonus or some type of benefit, now you can really hit on that fear of missing out. And at a live event, typically this would be like the event's over, and at the end of the event is the last time you can get the offer. If this is a sales page, it might be a legit launch. Like Tony and Dean Graziosi, Tony Robbins and Dean Graziosi, they went out there and created a launch. They did a lot of sales on the first day and a lot of sales on the last day. Why? Because there's the last day that you have to make a decision. So there's people that are emotional, but they've maybe done things before and it didn't work for them. Or they maybe bought things before, they might be holding on their dollars more. Maybe they know the logical things around it, but they're just scared to make a bad decision. Then all of a sudden when there's a countdown where there's an end to something, all of a sudden you'll see all those sales come in. I know that yesterday, Chipotle had this thing like last day to get free delivery. And I'm like, crap. Like if I don't get free delivery today, I'm gonna miss out. And they may come out with a new one later, but for this promotion, it's almost over. It was so interesting, I ended up ordering Chipotle and ordering above the amount that gave me free shipping, which really to them made them more money. And I probably invested more than I normally would because I didn't have to pay for the shipping of the item or the delivery of the item. And so those were the three things that we saw very valuable right now is catering the emotional buyers, logical buyers, and the FOMO buyers, the people that are motivated by the fear of missing out or urgency and scarcity. They need something that's urgent, something where there's a low amount, right? If there's only three cars left in the dealership at this investment and the deal ends for the rebate at the end of the week, we've seen this all of our life, but you can actually add that into your marketing as well. And the third thing is making sure that your product actually comes out as a new opportunity, not an improvement offer. An improvement offer is like, if you were to take something that people already do and make it better, like if you were to, right now, people are doing home workouts. So if I were to say, the way that you lose weight is if you go to the gym and you need my gym program. People are going to be like, man, I've already been to the gym. I've already tried gym workouts before and they didn't work for me. Or home workouts. Well, I've never done home workouts before because I'm just not motivated to work out from home. And so what happens is that people already think they know what you're talking about. I was talking to one of my clients that does refinancing and does mortgages. Everyone knows what that is. Oh, refinancing. The numbers don't work out. I don't think that's a good idea. Or whatever they've heard from their friends. Oh, getting a mortgage right now is not a good timing. So the only way he's going to grab their attention and get through the noise to get them to actually get a result is if he can get them to believe that there is a new style of an opportunity. It might just be changing the word. So an example would be like, oh, don't do home workouts. Do P90X. Don't go to the gym. Do CrossFit. Well, CrossFit's lifting weights, but oh no, it's a completely new way of lifting weights because look at you, like always are shocking your body every single day. And because you're shocking your body, it's going to give you this crazy result. Be like, oh my gosh, so amazing. You see people at home like twisting on these little plates on the ground because they're like, well, this is the way that I can lose weight without doing as much work. And like I could sit here and twist, and I'm going to get all these abs. And it targets the abs and it's like a new opportunity. It isn't an improvement on something else. So you want to get people to believe that this is a new opportunity. It should be a new opportunity. Yet so often we take this something that's so unique and so new and we make it relate to what they already know. And they're like, oh, I've already tried that before, so this won't work. And I remember my friend actually telling me this once. He said he had a supplement that was for sleep. And he's like, you know what? Let's make a new and improved version and we'll call it Sleep 2.0. And it failed because people are like, I don't want like just a better version of something that I've already seen. I want this new thing that came out that's going to be way better than anything else in the market. Because ultimately, at the end of the day, all of us are selling a result, a feeling, a result, some type of outcome that people are looking for. And knowing what that is really big. And this is like where people want to go. And what people are doing currently to be able to get to that place is what they're trying already. So if they're trying to lose weight, they might be starving themselves, doing home workouts, going to the gym, and they're not at this result yet. Because if they were, they wouldn't be looking at your stuff. And your goal is to create a new way for them to be able to get here where they go, oh my gosh, like this golf cart isn't going to get me across the country to where I want to be, but this Lamborghini, this new way that's faster, more, that'll get me to this end result. You want to position your offer in a way that's going to get them to that end result. And the last thing, the fourth thing, is actually something that I'm going to have to share on a different video because I just feel like it'll be too in-depth and make this one too long. So if you want me to drop a video on the fourth thing that I think is the most important thing right now in today's day and age, specifically for this time, and a little hint is facts tell, stories sell. We've always heard this before, but not in the way that it actually can improve every single area of your business and take it to the next level. And I want to do a video specifically on that. So if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Let me know if you want to know number four that I think is the most impactful thing that we've gone over with the clients, but I almost think is so impactful that I might have to hold out on it for a while to make sure that our clients get to implement it first off. But if I get enough people that say they want to hear it, I want to be able to break it down for you guys in a way that you can implement right away in four different ways that can dramatically see an impact in your current conversions and your current product or service to make a shift right now to get the marketplace attention on you. Thanks so much again for watching this video. Make sure to hit the subscribe button to be able to get more videos that we'll be dropping here while we're stuck in quarantine. Just do it even just if you want to see how my hair grows over the next month or so, which is going to be absolutely crazy. So appreciate you so much. We'll get a bunch of resources down in the description. Make sure to check them out and we'll talk to you soon.